Hello survivors, welcome back to another video. How are you today, guys? Let me know in the comments. Today, guys, I'm gonna show you one more time why you shouldn't be just rushing to get just plasma cores to get to HQ like plasma 5 or plasma 6 and ignoring all the important things like stats, like research, because some of you just think that everything is just about how high your HQ is, but it turns out that it is not that way. In this game, it's all about stats. So if you play smart and you invest the right resources in your stats or on your heroes, then believe me, you are gonna be even stronger than some plasma 6s and some plasma 5s. So I can see this every time in the reservoir rate and in state versus state, and in the Alliance Showdown. So I'm gonna show you here a couple of reports. I haven't done this in the past, but look, if you go here to the battles details, for example, battle reports, and you see here, so let's see my battles. So I won these two battles, and let's see who I fought again. So here, I had 166,000 troops. This person came with like lower level of troops because maybe he just won the other battle. Look at the difference in stats. And this person was plasma 6. So this plasma 5, sorry. This person was a plasma 5. I won the battle, of course, because I had more troops, more infantry. You could argue that. Well, if we go here to the second battle that I also won, look at this. I have 151,000 troops. This person has more troops than me, and I still beat him or her, yeah, beat him on stats. If we go here to the battle reports, this person has a plasma C HQ. He has more infantry than me, I guess. Yeah, more infantry than me, more troops, level higher troops, plasma 6, yeah. He didn't have plasma 6 infantry, but it had plasma 6 troops and the rest plasma 5. I only had plasma 4 troops, less infantry, less troops, and guess what? I beat the player and I just won the battle. So here is a clear example on what you have to focus on stats and not necessarily to go higher on like HQ levels, because you might be like a plasma 6, but you won't be able to beat a very, very strong plasma 4 or even plasma 5. So yeah, you can see here, if we go to the other battle, for example here, the second round, we had something similar, I guess. So here, if we go to the center, I won my first battle. And as you can see here, my stats are better. I was fighting a plasma 5. So, and this person had more infantry. Yeah, I sent more infantry, but plasma 4, we can see here. So I beat him on stats, and I also won the battle. And then if we go to the next one, look at how many troops. With 90K troops, I could injure from the enemy, and you see the difference in stats, and they see this player. This player is also plasma 6. So as you can see here, I'm 3 arrows above in stats than this plasma 6 player, and these are like other states. So yeah, you can see the difference. So if we go to the other report, the third round, let's see. So who did I fight in this round? I haven't seen this one. So if we go here, I won my first battle. Well, this player had less troops because it was coming from a wing from the other battle. But as you can see, I have better stats, and this player is this player is a full plasma 6. Maybe even can be plasma 7, but we never know because he has all the like troops plasma 6. And I won this player. Usually, a super strong plasma 6 with 80k troops will beat me if he has like a very good stats. But as you can see here, I'm better in stats than this plasma 6. So, and then the next one, I was about to win this one, and we are like even in stats. I beat him on infantry, he beats me on hunters and riders, and this person was a plasma 5. So as you can see here, guys, this is a clear example to why you have to prioritize first like stats, heroes, gears, and then you just go with the wave with the plasma HQ. And believe me, you don't have to rush. And yeah, there are some benefits, as I said in my video before, but I still find more benefits being lower like level HQ. I focus in my resources, because as a free-to-play player, you cannot have it all, you know? You cannot have all the plasmas, all the tactical gear designs, all the hero gear designs. You have to choose between events. What do you buy? Legendary heroes, tactical gear designs, or plasma core? So I have been focusing before on legendary hero fragments, tactical gear designs, gear material, and that's why I have like very good stats comparing to like plasma 6s or plasma like 5 for sure. And this doesn't just happen here, but also it happens a lot during state versus state, during like reservoir raid. And I'm not the only one. For example, if we go here, where is Hasbito? This is another girl who is playing super smart. Where is she? Maybe it's not in this one, in the second one. She is a plasma 3 beating plasma 4, plasma 5. So here, for example, yeah. Well, this one is just the last battle, but look at her stats. 800, 600, 700, troop attack 70. And when we are doing state versus state, she's just like blazing plasma 4, plasma 5 HQ, because she has very good stats, very good gears, and she's just plasma 3. So yeah, sometimes people think it's all about HQ. If you are a max player, yeah, it's super, super important. But as a free-to-play player, there must be a balance. Don't go all out for plasma HQ. Focus on your stats, your gear, and believe me, you are gonna be strong. So yeah, I just wanna remind you guys that. I hope you enjoy. See you next time.